Let's get buzzing.
All right. So let's kick it off with the hottest story in pop culture. Mm-hmm. And this is Prince Harry and Meghan.
Aww.
So Prince Harry and Meghan's surprise decision, at least to the members of the royal family, to split the confines of the palace life for North America and most likely Canada.
Okay.
It appears to be a more carefully plotted escape than anybody recognized.
Oh.
So it seems that they trademarked 100 items, including pencils, socks, and bookmarks, to their Sussex Royal brand more than 6 months ago, according to the Daily Mail. In that move, so this is what it says, that it could probably set them aside to pursue them.
Okay.
What would they call it? Financial independence.
Ah,
so that's this is what they want to do. This is what the couple is looking for.
So
they're looking for financial independence
from the royal
family. But it can't be easily done. However, a couple like this saying that they want to move towards financial independence is really weird, because them padded by £34 million from royal grants and as well. But
they're already financially independent.
Yeah. So basically what they want to do is they want to start a life on their own and apart from the confines of the royal family.
Mm-hmm. I'm not surprised.
I'm not surprised either, but moves like this, you can't do these things so easily.
Why not, though? Oh, so easily.
Yeah, so easily. I'm not saying it's impossible, but you will always be tired and you will always be associated to the royal family.
I said it, that it sounds like the mafia. Like, it's once you're in it until death.
This is more serious than the mafia. This is a country.
Yeah, but in this time when things are changing and
a country with so much colonies around the world.
Yeah, but generational changes and the world is changing, maybe. Because it's happened in the sense of, we've seen the movies where things like this, topics like this happen. And in the movies they find a way. Maybe in real life we're coming to a point where we're going to see where, you don't think it'll happen?
No.
Let me see. Let's
not
give them a chance.
Sunny,
it might happen some years.
Right now, on a Sunday, if you go on the road, people are going to say daytime live or altogether sing.
Yes.
Or TVJ.
Uh-huh.
Because you're associated.
Yes.
Right? If me go up on the road, I'm going to say to you, okay, same way. They're going to say daytime live, same way. Because I'm associated. Even though we've gone our separate ways, we're
cool.
Associated. And that will forever be. And that is a group.
But are they?
This is a royal family.
Queen Elizabeth,
about 200 years old.
Or are they just trying to step aside a little bit as a couple and live a life that they want to choose, since the life was chosen for them?
I understand the desire.
Maybe they want to try something.
I understand the desire, but how do you get away from it? Really, you can't.
No, they'll always be identified as Prince Harry and Meghan.
So why step aside?
But maybe they just want to try something different. And is that so bad?
No, nothing wrong with that. Nothing wrong with that. But who will pay for it?
That is taxpayers' money. Brand them team. They branded their stuff, so they have things in place from 6 months ago planning to run off.
Oh, them brand pencil. So the pencil
the
pencils, them, so the pencil never got paid for the royal, the royal
so
trips.
So we're
going to
sell the things. They're going to be vendors now and sell them. And
so the £34 million, what them leave with? Where that come from?
It come from the people in London who pay for it.
And we too, Governor General, we still appear them too.
Listen, if it can happen, sometimes you don't know if it can work unless you try some. So maybe them just want to try it.
Yeah, man, but these things you can't just be whimsical like that. You have to really pay attention and know.
But isn't the Queen trying to see how they can work it out?
Yeah, that's what she says. Them trying to find a workable solution.
She's probably so annoyed. So upset.
Yeah,
but
problem.
As we talk about branding and selling things, right, I think this other story is slightly appropriate. Workers employed to the Kingston and St. Andrew Municipal Corporation were hired to demolish, once again, vending stalls on the sidewalks of Princess Street, Beckford Street, Orange Street, Haywood Street, all in downtown Kingston. So the police were there providing security for the workers, and the corporation is on a drive to restore public order in the city. And somehow I'm having a deja vu moment. I keep hearing that. So many people have mixed opinions on social media. Some people are saying, it's poor people, and questioning how the vendors are actually going to survive, while others are saying that there's a designated place for them to sell. So basically nothing is wrong if we remove them from where they are now. Well, a shop owner managed to tweet that she may be able to make a one and two sale because her former customers could not be bothered to navigate through the chaos. And I think what she's saying is, once she's moved, yeah, one or two people might come and buy, but that traffic that she's used to, she's not going to get anymore. Where others feel as if it's just a New Year's show, and by next week, it's back to normal.
But Moss.
And they're back out there. But I think we do this every year.
No, but Moss, if you don't provide a workable solution, then it would always happen. So it is said that there's a place there for them, but is that place enough? And is it at the right place? Because at the end of the day, once, let me tell them, people will always try to find a way to make the dollar. Mm-hmm. They will always try to find out if the dollar is over here and they're provide a space for them them going to go over here fight.
Mm-hmm.
Whether or not there's a space provided for them or not over here, they're going to figure out a way to stay over here. And
because the place you provided is not working for them to get the dollar.
As many times as you tear it down, they're going to build it back up.
All right. So here's, to add to that, my other challenge, and this is an overall challenge, is where we do these big activities and we make these big steps for a change and then we don't maintain it. So, okay, we constantly every year we're removing, and this is just one example of how we manage and how we have governance here in this country and other countries. Mm-hmm. We make this big change, we implement this new rule and this new order, and then there's nothing to maintain and to keep it efficient. So have we ever sat with, I think there was a time when we met with the vendors to ask them what they needed, what works, but I don't recall if we actually listened and actually created the space in such a way that it works for them. So we're gonna do this every single year.
Yeah, the biggest issue with that is that there's no unified body. So even though
to represent
the vendors. So I mean, even though a group might agree to a certain type of behavior, a certain practice, then the new group and the new crop, when they come in, they might not.
Can't fall in line. There's nobody to maintain it again. Okay. Well, wishing all the best. Let's see.
Yeah, let's see what happens. Maybe we can find a solution. You know, we have an expert. We're going to talk about an expert at finding things right now.
I have a big yard space and I have a big yard space.
You have a big yard space?
Big yard space. Yeah.
All right, so Sanik will host the vending. All right, so Elephant Man has been on the road to fitness. Yeah, everyone can see him and health, and he's with trainer Patrice White. But it hasn't been very easy for him.
It wouldn't.
And we have but he might go on good still based on what I've been seeing. But anyway, check out this video.
Check out this video.
Chef.
So, that was Elif's kitchen, so. Can you get out now, please?
2 days later.
One. Bro, so I'm going to cook in my yard.
Bro, two.
What kind of gym this?
Bro. So, Ellis, after me have a conversation and you can't do it here, I'll give you
a book. Then I'm white rice, I'm going to grow.
Come, let's go.
I'm going to grow up about white rice.
You go.
Who don't eat white rice?
Four. Ellis, that big pot of white rice?
Yeah.
Go, five.
No, my friend, let me cook.
Is that right? Five. You want to show you the dishes? So, you show? Drop back down, we need that 9 more times. Let's go. 9 more times.
Shoot,
9 more times. Ready? Ready? Let's go. Pull up. Again, drop back down. Drop back down. 8 more times. Ready? Lie down flat. Lie down flat, man. Lie down flat. Lie down flat when you're on social media.
I'm not laughing.
Hey, Patrice, they're up for body bump still.
Patrice, bad up everybody,
yeah,
though.
Yeah, yeah,
Patrice,
yeah.
Bad up anybody. That was day one. Oh, gosh. That was day one.
Day one.
So we're going to see before and after. See, this is day one.
About
and
day
then
20, that
one. 90 days later, we're going to see a different type of video.
No, but he shed the pounds already. We can see it.
Yeah?
Yeah, man.
I didn't notice.
Yeah, man. From the first day. Yeah, man, Ellie did a rundown to love the belly thing, man.
He's very chatty, though. Like, he's going back at Patrice.
But he's always there, though.
Going back at
Patrice. Yeah, man, Ellie dedicated, man. It's going to work.
Well, I'm rooting for you because I'm trying to rope in Craigie to basically help me out in the same way.
I mean, you made me bad up people to it.
Climb no rope here.
No, you're going to have to climb rope.